veterans, friends, ladies and gentlemen. On this, our 93rd ANZAC Day, our 93rd day of solemn national commemoration, it is natural that our thoughts will turn first to the brave men who landed ANZAC Cove on that fateful Sunday morning, in honour, their courage and their sacrifice.
Today, where we celebrate the freedom that is ours. A day where we pray for peace. Peace in our local communities. Peace in our state. Peace in our nation. And in particular, peace in places of war and hostilities around the globe. Yes, this is the day that unites us like no others.
I'm marching with young Australians. Harold Stan Trumpton was killed on the bloody front line of France in 1917. A fellow soldier came with a left back to his family and said that he lived, that he died as he lived, courageously and in honour. One young mother widowed, one boy who never grew up with his father by his side, one young man sacrificed in battle for his country. Ladies and gentlemen, here is just one story of service and sacrifice that could be repeated more than 106,000 times today across our country. One story that reminds us that a life marked by service and sacrifice.
O Lord, through the mouth of your prophet, declare that all souls are yours. We thank you for the brave and faithful dead who willingly laid down their lives on the battlefield in war, or succumb to the perils of the deep or the air. We bless you for the dauntless courage of those defenders of our Commonwealth who have fallen in the cause of truth and righteousness. In your hands, O Father, we leave their departed spirits. Grant us to follow their good example in faithfulness and endurance, even unto death, that we may with them be found worthy of the crown of everlasting life.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand for the playing of The Last Post, the lament played by the pipes and drums of Scots College, the recital of the Ode, and the playing of Reveille by the bugler, and then please remain standing until after Advance Australia Fair. Please be seated.
Yeah.